your most, what is your most memorable match to commentate? Which one was it?
I've had two experiences. Once when the US and Iran were playing.
Mm.
You know, that had
that was a very bad war.
Political significance of it is what actually carried the game. It wasn't much about the game itself on the field. It's just this political significance. Who's going to win it? And what's the implications of that? So in the minds of those who are in politics, that was a big game.
Yeah.
But you remember that France lost to Brazil lost to France. In the 1998 World Cup, on a day when all odds were against France.
How do you people cram the faces of this human being? How do you, because from where you're standing, I'm pretty sure you're just seeing some things going around, It's not like people have numbers standing on top of their head. How do you know that is creme de la creme, that is Dr. Funek?
You know, now things have been made easier because they have jersey numbers and names. Eh?
Mm.
They have names on their jerseys, but it's not that you can see that distance. Eh?
Mm.
But they're only 11 on one side. When you're a commentator, when you're in this industry, you develop a photographic memory. If I close my eyes, I can tell you who's wearing what on this other side and who's
Are
wearing
you serious?
What. Yeah, well, you have to see it in your mind. So even in a football pitch, there is what is called the tactical team sheet that shows you where they should be lining up. I'm not saying they're going to be stationary, but you generally expect that the man in front of the goalkeeper will be the last
supposed
man.
To be someone.
You generally expect that.
But I'm very curious about this. Like, subconsciously, do you guys ever feel that you're taking sides, you know?
Mm.
Like, you're probably taking sides somehow, like...
Let me tell you something, and Jacob will probably confirm this. It takes a lot of wits. It takes a lot of wits, a lot of self-control to be not biased. It takes a lot, because... If a Kenyan is playing, if a Kenyan team is playing, for example, you are expected that you'll take sides. But you know, unfortunately, with television, there's pictures. You can't say Kenya is winning. or that they have scored a goal. And you know what has happened. Eh?
No, Kenyans have scored goals, though, in a PlayStation. Let me ask, Jacob, is there at any point where you've ever confused? Like you mentioned a wrong player with the ball.
Really? Does it happen? Because before you open your big mouth, you really need to confirm number 13, then you pause a little bit. There is no hurry of naming a player.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I just like Dr. Ofuneke in jersey 14, before he scores a goal, before you go saying it's Bernard who has scored, you need to really to have that memory and remember the number, then you confirm before you go on air.
So you can't just be going mentioning.
But first time experiences can also be very nerve wracking.
Mm.
I remember one, the West Africans, the Nigerians, the Cameroonians, the Ghanaians, they take sides. Mm. So obviously, it, like you're saying, subconsciously they take sides.
Mm.
But I remember this one guy who it was his first experience at the World Cup, and the replays, you know, they're coming like six of them from different angles.
Wow.
And the guy had scored a goal. And so there was a replay of the goal, and this commentator was like, and they have scored again.
Replays.
It was the replay. Oh, and they've scored a second goal in just 2 minutes.
Yeah.
You had to tap him and tell him, no, it's a replay.
That is something.
Ofeneke, but let me tell you, we have a watchman at home. Like, he really, like, you know those guys who watch football on the radio?
Yes.
Like, how are people able to do that, fam? Because I can't. Like, especially when you guys are commentating, how do you, like, you know, cater for those kind of guys who, you know, like, you know, they're listening to on radio?
Mm.
You know, those are two different media.
Right.
And what happens is on radio, it's got to be a little bit animated.
Right.
There's no doubt about it.
You have to make it
you're
interesting.
You're creating the pictures in the minds of the viewers. They don't see the pictures.
Yeah.
They don't have the visuals when they're on radio.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So the picture has to be created.
Wow.
You must use a lot of adjectives, a lot of descriptive words.
Yeah.
That is why if you put on the radio and then you watch TV on the same game,
on the same
it's
very two different vibes.
You think you're watching the same game.
So will I be wrong to say that you people have actually mastered an art of trying to cram the name by producing a certain sound? That one, alelelele. I realize it's an excuse, eh? Like, I can see, which player is that?
Like, you're buying time.
I wish you were listening to the commentary of that Mexican game in their language.
No, for me it sounded like
or even
a soap
Brazilian.
Opera.
Yeah. Yes.
Because you're talking about Kenyan commentators and the way they go that, and that's Swahili. You haven't listened to South American commentators. Let me tell you. And they do commentary on radio. I remember one of the experiences, I think it was in South Africa for the World Cup, I was also there, and the goal had been scored. I remember the goal had been scored. But even as we were going on with the game, I could still hear this guy say, go!
Are they once too
the long? Goal was scored about 10 minutes later, he is still on the goal. I'm serious. He's still enjoying the goal. Remember, sometimes they do what they're just calling highlights. Mm. They're not commentating the whole match, especially on radio. Mm. So they're maybe commentating the first 10 minutes and then they stop.
Yes.
Maybe in their country now they're doing something else. Adverts, maybe just a normal programming. Mm. And then they stop again at some point. If a goal is scored, he has to tell them, "Hey, goal has been scored now." So they open up the mic for him again.
Go. But at least now I understand. Yeah. I understand about the Mexicans rather than Brazilians. Oh, But I'm probably sure that's the reason then why India, they are never commentators from India.
You haven't seen that video of the Indian commentator when Ronaldo scored from the free kick.
Yeah. I didn't see that.
Oh my goodness, you should hear it then. He's worse than the South American commentator.
Did he start dancing?
You know, the worst thing is, he's also putting English in it. Oh, Ronaldo has scored. But
then he's done celebrating the first goal. The second goal is already...
They're going to have time.
So you've got to be a little bit crazy in your mind as well to